These are essential ingredients that go into the growth.
So your answer is no. So your answer is no. Let there be another disaster. I hear your answer. Your answer is no. Let there be another disaster. Let more people die. Let there be more erosion. Let more buildings be destroyed. Let there be another flash flood, and we'll say even then it was a deluge.
If you're not willing to allow me to make my point, and if you're simply going to pass your judgment, I will.
Please make your point directly.
At least allow me to complete my point.
Directly.
I am trying to make it directly, very much directly. But having said that, does it mean that it should all come at the cost of the environment? No.
No, I am asking you a specific question. I am not asking you, Mr. Baidegada, for any. I am not asking you for your general views. Mr. Baidegada, 1 minute.
Question.
Mr. Baidegada, no, on the news.
I am answering your question.
Please do.
I am answering your question. If you would please listen to me, I am answering your question. It need not come at the cost of the environment, but all that I am trying to say is that we are as committed.
Mr. Baidegada, you're not answering the question.
Environment, because it means
you are not answering. You're going around in circles. I don't know why. I don't know why. Mr. Baidegada, today. Mr. Baidegada.
If I want to know today, I want to protect the environment.
Mr. Baidegada, I don't want
to. Politicians, we need to listen to all people in the society, which means.
Mr. Gowda, why?
The people who are living
Mr. Gowda, you know, it's a very long answer, but it comes to nothing.
And strike a development,
Mr. Baidegada. Mr.
Gowda,
today.
Objectives.
Okay, so,
we need to have
so
a
Mr. Gowda.
Approach. That's my point.
Mr. Gowda, please understand.
I've made my point.
You've not made the point. It may be your point, it makes no sense. The question is, there is a letter which is written on the 18th of December 2012. Okay? In this letter, it is said the Congress Chief Minister writes to the Congress government. Please don't allow this eco-sensitive zone proposal to happen, right? This is the one letter which I have. Today it is the 19th of June. About 150 people have died and there has been so much destruction. I'm not asking you for a general theoretical treatise, Mr. Gowda, with greatest of respect on your views between ecology and development. I am asking you whether you can junk this proposal in the way that you are about to junk. It is as simple as that. You can say yes or no to that.
No, you're the one who is junking. I'm not junking anything.
Your government junked it, Mr. Gowda. Your government junked it.
On the specific issue.
Your government junked it.
No, I'm not junking anything. My government is not junking anything.
Your government officially junked it.
My government is not junking anything. My government is.
Well, I don't know. I don't know if that's the impression you carry. Then it's wrong.
Once the rescue efforts are in place, once we are able to deal with the emergency situation, I think we cannot junk it. We cannot junk the proposal of
good.
The Prime
I'm just so sorry. I'm just so sorry, Mr. Gowda.
I'm just so sorry tonight
that it takes so many people to die, so many people to lose their lives, so many houses to be broken down, so many people to be affected for you to make that realization. I'm just so sorry that it takes a disaster of this kind, which your party doesn't even call a disaster, it calls a deluge. I'm just so sorry, but please, Shazia, I wanted to respond to you. Mr. Baidegada.
The important question is what happens now? From now to the next disaster, what are we planning? Do these people who are there in the government, whether it's the Congress government or the BJP, do they inspire faith in or confidence in the people that the next disaster will not happen, hopefully, and if it does, will be tackled well? And lesser people will die. So what I need to know is there any understanding of the situation and how grave it is? And also, what kind of policy is being made on a war footing to prevent more disasters like this to happen?
Well,
it's important to know for people to inspire some confidence from now on, from the next disaster, what are the steps that are going to be taken?
Yes, Mr. Anjan.
Uttarkashi. 10 years back, there was an earthquake in Uttarkashi. At that point of time, lot of environmentalists, many important people came. There was a report But nobody looked back, and we started playing with the entire area in environment. Have we drawn any lesson from the earthquake of 10 years back in Uttarkashi, where 1,000 people were killed?
Well, I
think we have not drawn any lesson out of that, and still we are playing with the entire area. And this is the point which we have to see.
Once yes,
again,
Mr. Duggal.
Committee and all that. What will happen?
So the simple question is this: 1 minute. The political parties, and that's why the political parties don't want to stop the construction of various buildings, hotels, new age resorts, walking paths for tourism, pilgrimage, local use, illegal mining, stone quarrying, and crushing.
Listen.
1 minute.
Listen.
So, Mr. Duggal, please understand. What you are saying is, let's improve our meteorological census so we get to know when the flash floods happens, etc., how the weather will be. But Mr. Duggal, you are missing the most critical point, that the political parties cannot take on business interests. The political parties in a state are representing strong business and economic interests. These are the same groups which provide them funding when it comes to an election. They don't have, with the greatest of respect, the courage or the ability to take on these business interests. And that's why we must, at least on Times Now, I want to come to the point. I don't want to run around in circles on this.
I'm not getting an assurance
from the Congress and the BJP tonight, which have been in power.
No, but 80% of the discussion has moved on that only.
No, but we are not getting an assurance, Mr. Duggal, are we? Meenakshi Lekhi is not giving us an assurance.
Final point, what I wish to make is that apart from rescue operations, etc., so far as this particular notification and any eco-sensitive zone, any construction and anything, there should not be a bogey one way or the other that you can't really construct roads, you can't do this, you can't do that. There has to be a more balanced approach and nationwide policy on these issues. If it's not just the riverbed of Ganges, it's the riverbed of Yamuna, it's the riverbed of several other
Let's have a policy.
Can I make my point? I'm saying so far as ecological methods are concerned, whether it's generating electricity, whether it's construction, it's quarrying, everything needs to have a scientific outlook. Somehow I feel either we take one extreme or or we take the other extreme.
Ms. Lekhi,
I think we need
I'm glad you admit that the policy should not change with the change of government. For God's sake,
the deep ecology which comes into this country comes through Hinduism, and don't give it a communal flavor or a religious flavor.
No, that's not important.
Talk about
that
Don't sidetrack. It's a very important issue.
I want to go back to Sunita Narayan. I am not sure, Sunita Narayan, if today either party goes among the people and says, you wanted us to block the eco-sensitive proposal. I want the BJP and the Congress to go to the people of Uttarakhand and say, you invited the disaster on yourself. Mm. They will never say so. But in the letters they write to the state governments, to central governments, the arguments they put, they only shoot off the shoulders of the people. So, final question to you, Sunita Narayan. Do you think the political parties will be made
to answer now? It's not only the political parties, it's also the bureaucracy.
Absolutely.
You should also catch hold of the Ministry of Environment and tell them that...
No, absolutely not, Arnab. Not from what I'm hearing, because I'm hearing from both Meenakshi, who I respect a lot, and Mr. Gowda, is the fact that they would like to say, pit this between environment and development. But it's actually about if they believe that they can... go to the people, they need to explain to the people that they can have development, but they don't need to build 70 dams. They need to build a certain number of dams, which will give them some energy and they're going to make it well. But they don't do that. They want the 70 dams. They're in the construction business. They're not in the energy business.
Absolutely. Well, I hope that message goes home.
That's the big issue.
And I hope that we are not seeing them
step up to the game and understand how the future of the Himalayas is at stake today.
Well, certainly, and the lives of a lot of people. To all my panelists, I thank you very much for joining us. Well, today we saw one chief minister lose his cool when we asked him the tough questions. Let me assure both him and the other politicians, we'll have many more tougher questions on this in the coming few days.